get over this. Okay, so that was, so why did you ask me this question? Okay, so I thought these kind of encounters, you know, like suddenly I would be in the Himalayas, lost, and there would be a, I would be lost in the Himalayan peaks, and somebody with a long hair would appear and say, why don't I help you and get me out? And then I won't know where, who helped me, because that man would disappear. And that's when you start believing that there are some divine experiences that helps you to carry on, isn't it? Because otherwise you won't be in such spaces. Let me tell you, share one secret also with you. In all my travels abroad, in all my travels in India, all these years, that is 20, 25 years nearly, not even one flight was cancelled.
Wow.
Okay, it has landed somewhere else. It has never been cancelled. This is a great God's gift, isn't it? Yeah, when things don't happen, when things don't happen and it happens, then it becomes, then that's when I started, so I wanted to bring out a book for that. Then the first question everyone said, ma'am, where did you get this? Where did you get this? So I would have, because every country I visit, everywhere I go, I pull out something from it. Okay, so this actually is from Greece. Okay, I went recently to Greece, I stayed with Sheila. And in Greece, I saw this, it was expensive. I left, and that lady, I still remember in that shop. She came, she called me. She said, I know you're not going to buy it. That's how she said. I know you're not going to buy it. Okay, and then she called me, and she said, you know what? You just try this on. Okay? So she put me on. She said, you look beautiful. I said, yes, I know. And then she said, you take it, I bring down the price. Okay? And if you can't buy this time, next time when you come to Greece, you can still buy it. I'll be there. And she gave me her card. Okay? And then she put another one on me and another one. So I said, okay, fine. I mean, I know for sure I'm not going to buy it. So I went back and then we had a festival there. So after the festival, I know that this was a festival where they were not paying me any honorarium. Mm-hmm. There was no money given for this. But that man who organized the festival, Dimitris. So Dimitris called me and said, I think it's not fair that you come all the way to Greece and I don't pay you anything. So he took a little money in the pocket and gave me, and that money was exactly the cost of this money. So this is one story. So it had to be bought. So I had to find that shop right now. So I went, and that lady was out, coming out of the shop, because there was a row of shops. So I forgot which shop. But that lady came out, ah, hola, hello, she said. I said, yeah, chain. I said, yes. So sometimes, you know, in Tamil we say, for the pickle thaisada, that is all pickle curd rice. So because I bought this chain, I had to buy a sari. So my daughter asked me one question, Amma, how do you find time? And I don't have any patience to do that. But you see, the time is also given by God, because every time we finish, sometimes, you know, we are, I feel I need rest. So that day I'll be fully fresh and alive. That is the day I do shopping. So anyway, so I think this is one story of my chains and my sarees.
Yeah. And one more serious note. So how important is it, you think, to create a separate identity when you are a student? Do you think that is something that you should calculate?
Yeah, so I think there are so many storytellers today. And each one has a skill, their own skills. So, when there are some people who learn a skill, and they learn that they know to learn so quickly. They discover that they can learn so quickly, which I never knew I would learn. This is one type of audience. The other type of audience is when you teach a skill, they say, oh, I knew this. How come I didn't discover it for all these years? And they discover it. Now some of them say, we are born long storytellers. Some of them say, from childhood I've been telling stories. But that doesn't matter. As long as it has helped to discover, some people also unlearn. Many people have come and said, I know I found my calling. And they have resigned big jobs for which I'm not responsible to become a storyteller. But maybe that's the hope and faith in them, right? So it has done many things to many people. So I think that is one of the strengths of a storyteller.
Whenever I've seen you watch other people tell stories, you have enjoyed so much, and you are completely glued onto it. And as much as people enjoy your story, you have that ability to enjoy what other people tell, even though even speaking you are there and
right.
In your view, what was the best story that you ever
told? Oh. That's a tough question. Okay, so I think some of the best storytellers, especially in the 108 batches, better storytellers than the storytellers of today. They are not performing, but they have stayed in my mind. They are not practicing storytelling. I don't know where they are, but I think some of the best practitioners have come from, they say, you know, while small souls lurk in large areas, large souls lurk in smaller ones. So this is what I would conclude. Some of the stories that have stayed in my mind have been those beautiful people who are presented in my batches, rather than the professional storytellers that I have heard. Thank you. I'm going to ask questions. So I was hoping that he'll ask me the right question. And not because you are, I can also get caught unaware, right? So thank you, Meena. Thank you very much for this.